Hey guys, and welcome back to another Pixel Punch episode. And as you can see, I made some progress since our last episode. I got some full diamond gear over here, a sword, you know, shovel, axe, all of that, and an elytra. Yeah, all of these things will really help us, though we don't have a lot of rockets, which is a problem, but yeah, well, that's fine. At least we could, you know, we could go ahead and build at higher heights without worrying about fall damage that much. So yeah, this is all good. And today, what we're gonna do is kind of a big build because I feel like last episode, I wasn't really able to show my chops that much. All I did was build a hogland farm, which you know, which is really cool. But you know, still, I feel like I could do a lot more, and I have a lot more to show you guys. So as you can see, yeah, there's a lot of villagers here. We of course do need more because this is gonna be a really big iron farm. If you've seen this design before, it's actually Nembom's huge mega iron farm. So yeah, that's what we're gonna build today. And I got some glass because we're gonna make this out of glass, and we're gonna start off over here at the top of this scaffolding tower. So yeah, just build some glass perimeter around. Actually, I should look at the build later on in a creative world just so that I know exactly how to build it. So yeah, I'll probably cut to a later part of the video where more stuff is being built out. So yeah, look at this thing, you guys. It's massive. Well, at least for an iron farm it is. So yeah, I'm pretty much done building the entire thing. I even made a small storage system in the back, and all that's left to do is of course add the villagers, and I'm also gonna add a zombie to this thing. And I already put in some villagers in two of the modules. I'll just go up there and show it to you guys. And yeah, I don't think you can see them because of entity render distance. But they're there. Yep, there they are. They're just over here, as you can see. And the server's a little bit laggy right now because there's so many people online. But that's cool. This is a good thing. Many people online means the server is really active and we have a really good community here. I'll just remove these things just so that we can continue this line over there and build more rails on that side. And yeah. So now I can just go over here and build up more rails. Whoops. Oh, no. Okay, that was dumb. Let's just go back down, and I don't have any rockets on me right now because I'm pretty much out of gunpowder, which means that either I have to purchase gunpowder from somebody or I need to make my own mob farm. And I don't know, mob farm's not really priority on my list, so we might just buy some rockets if somebody opens up a rocket shop. We'll have to see. Yeah, did I? Okay, whatever. Let's just go over there and continue. So now we could get a villager. And there we go. Nice. It's gonna go all the way up to the module that we have over there, and it's stopping because of the lag. I don't know if it's on my side or server side, but yeah, it's kind of laggy. And yeah, it's stopping here because of this contraption over here. And yeah, let's just continue on. Go to your module. Go over there. Oh crap! And we also forgot, I don't know if you saw that, we forgot to curve the rails. Wait. Hold on, let's just go all the way back up. And I think the villager's gonna continue circling around until we go over there and fix it. There we go. Just curve the rails. And yeah, he's gonna make his way back through. Can we just push him? Nah, let's just wait. Let's wait for him. There. And yeah, let's just do that a bunch of more times until we get all of the villagers in. This is gonna take a while, but not too long. Not too long. So that's all of the villagers in place, and these are around 30 villagers, so yeah, it took us a while, like a few hours to get all of the villagers here. And yeah, except for one, actually. There's one over here that we need to wait to grow up before we get him out of the minecart, that guy, over there. So yeah, we just need to wait for him to grow up, and then we can bring him out of the minecart, and yeah, it's all smooth sailing from then on. And of course, we just need to get a zombie up here to scare the villagers and spawn the golems, and I'm probably gonna have the zombie spawn down there over at that island, but of course, it's still daytime. And I'll probably inform later my server mates not to sleep. Hopefully they won't sleep. I don't know. Oh, what the hell? What are you doing up here? You're not supposed to be up here. You're supposed to fall. Oh, well, I fell down, but you're supposed to fall down too. Hold on. I'll fix this. Just gonna go up here. Push you off. Get off. Stop jumping. There. Okay. All good. And we don't actually need more villagers because our entire iron farm is full. But you know, it's good to have a few spares. And you know, we might actually still use this villager breeder in the future for, I don't know, trading halls or something. I'm not entirely sure. But at the moment, we're not yet building a trading hall. We just buy books from other people because Jelly and Danny have their own trading hall, which, you know, just go to, buy their books, it's fine. Now we just have to wait until nighttime. Okay, nice, we actually got a zombie over here, and we just need to, if that skeleton doesn't calm down a bit. I don't have a bow. Anyway, yeah, let's just get that zombie all the way over here. Kill that skeleton, man. Oops. Okay. Kill the skeleton. Come on, zombies. Can they not pathfind through the bamboo? Come on, come over here. They're really slow. Come on. Get over here. There. Oh, okay, let's get up here. And trap them. Haha. Okay, we got a few zombies. Let's check if if they hold items. Give them some netherrack. Do any of you hold items? Any of you? Any of the two of you hold items? No. Okay. Fine. We'll get this guy. This guy holds items. He held a bone. Come on. You're good. Come over here. Get over here. Okay. There we go. We got him. So yeah, after a while, I reconfigured the rails. This should probably work. It's using the what do you call that? The curved rail trick. And by placing it here, yeah. There we go. The zombie should make its way all the way up. Without a hitch. Okay, nice. It's going backwards, though. It's not supposed to go backwards. It's going backwards. We need to fix that. We just need to stand here, right? And push. Nope. That didn't work. But hey, iron golems are spawning. We don't have lava. I just realized that we haven't placed any lava yet. So yeah, we need to do that. Let's just go back up and turn off one of the paths. That's probably what we need to do. But hey, it's working because iron golems are spawning. It's just that they're not dying because we don't have lava. And yeah, we just turned off this path. That's probably actually, let's just go over here and turn off the path over here. So it's more convenient for us, I guess. This one. Okay. Just wait for him. And yeah, iron golems are spawning, but not dying. Oh, okay. Oh, that was dumb. That was really dumb. Anyways, let's go ahead and get some lava, and you should die. Okay, so we found a huge lava lake underground. So yeah, let's just get some. Oh, no. Did I? Yeah, okay. That's fine. I brought more iron. And what can I get rid of in my inventory? Just get rid of that. This. I don't need those. Just get this back and craft up another bucket. Okay, do we have enough space? Yes, as long as we can leave that there. 2, 3, 4. Okay. Yeah. With enough space in our inventory. Yeah. That's 5, right? Yep. That's 5. Okay, now let's just go all the way back to our iron farm and place in the lava buckets. And yeah, I think we're pretty much done once we've done that. So, all good. Okay, so Super Gamer just came up to us with an offer. Unlimited iron for 8 netherite scraps. 8 netherite ingots, I mean. So, yeah, that's actually an amazing deal. Because as you can see, we're just full on diamond right now, nothing netherite, and having some netherite stuff would really help us out. So yeah, sure, unlimited iron for a few pieces of netherite, yeah, why not? And oh, there's someone over here working on a bee farm. Yeah. I'm headed to the apocalyptic district. So yeah, we'll probably just meet up here in the apocalyptic district, and yeah, we'll make the deal. And anyways, I'm almost done with my iron farm, so it's actually great timing. Where here? Ooh. Yeah, this one over here is Stone's Iron Farm, and as you can see, he's AFK down there. Okay, yeah, it's producing a decent amount. Good job, Stone. That's really cool. A lot of guardrails are happening, making sure that everything falls into place. But yeah, oh there's Super. Yo. Hey, nice. Let's just get rid of these. That's trash. You can come over to my iron farm anytime you want. What's that sound? Is that you? Okay, let's fly over there. Come on! This way! Oh yeah, and I got some rockets, because I'll talk about later how I got some rockets. And here is the iron farm. Look at it! Look at it in all its glory! Come on, Super! And yeah, while we're here, we could just place the lava buckets now and start making it work, because it's not working yet. And yeah, see, a bunch of iron golems are over here clogged up, and just by placing this lava bucket there, no longer clogged up anymore. And I hate the fact that iron golems are so noisy when they die. It's really bothersome, especially when you have an iron farm near your base. Yeah, the noise just really bothers you, because it sounds like torture, really. Not torture for me, but like torture for them. I feel bad. I kind of feel bad a little bit, you know, for what I'm doing to them. But at the same time, I don't really feel bad at all. But yeah. Okay. What? Just get rid of that. Yeah, I have a bunch of items over here clogging up the item filters. But yeah, that should be good, and all of the poppy should end up here sooner or later. Okay, let's just go over here and put in the... Oh, I fell. That's fine. Get the other lava buckets ready. And come over here to the other side. And yeah, did Super leave already? He probably left. He was just like, oh, admire the view, and bye-bye. Okay. Now on this side... Hi guys, now you die. And last but not least, more lava over here. Okay, that's good. We're all good. Let's go check over our storage system. Yeah. And let's check. Yeah, poppies aren't really a common drop, so I get why there's no filter items there yet. And yeah, that's pretty much it. We're probably gonna AFK here for a little bit later. And after we AFK, of course, we're gonna check out our profits for all of the work that we've done. And what the hell happened here? Oh, because we use normal ice. And yeah, sometimes Dolphin's Grace is annoying. We use normal ice instead of packed ice, so those melted. Crap. I didn't realize that. Do we have... we have a few pieces of packed ice. I think we can make it work. Yeah. Okay, that's easy. Let's just replace all of the normal ice with packed ice, and we should be all good. So I just replaced all of the ice near the lava with packed ice, and as you can see, it's already in working order, and it's working amazing. Man, that's so much iron golems dying. This is so great. Let's just fly around and see it in its full... and see it in its full glory. There we go. I'm terrible at flying. Okay, yeah. So let's just turn around and look at that. That looks amazing. And I'm just in love with this view. Oh, and by the way, let's just land over here. I got something to show you guys. Oh, okay, there. You ready? You ready? Bam! Yeah, I got full netherite already. You know, because Sansan gave us some netherite ingots a while ago. And yeah, I just used it to, you know, make a bunch of netherite armor and a few netherite tools as well. So yeah, I got a netherite sword and netherite pick. I didn't make a netherite shovel or axe yet, but we will do that soon once we save up on more netherite. I feel like that's we can save up on that for a different time. And yeah, it's already producing a lot of iron, actually. It's only been... I don't know, it's only been running for a few minutes, and yeah, that's already like two or more stacks of iron. So yeah, it's a really efficient farm, and I love Nembom for designing it. He's really amazing. So yeah, I'll probably just AFK here for 2 or 3 hours maybe. I'll see. So yeah, I'll just dig a hole in the ground somewhere. Like right here. There you go. And okay, we have to... there. Okay. And let's just wait over here for, I don't know, more iron. Okay, so it's been a few hours. Now let's check on our iron profits. Okay. Okay, not bad. It's, let's check here. Yeah, not bad. I mean, it's, 2.5 double chests, which is okay, I guess. And yeah, some poppies too. Not a bad iron profits right there. So yeah, the next thing we need to do, actually we need to grab some iron because we need it for our next project. Because right now what we're gonna do is that we're doing a, not a favor, because it's more of a collaboration. Yeah, a collaboration with Vandal Boy, because he asked us to help him with a storage system in his gold farm. And of course, because of that, we can probably use the gold farm, because of course we're building the storage system for it. So yeah, so we're gonna go over there, grab some redstone and other stuff, and leave a bunch of stuff behind, and yeah, probably build the gold farm for Vandal Boy's, the storage system for Vandal Boy's gold farm. What? So yeah, just let me grab some materials and we'll head over there right now. Okay, so we're over here at Vandal Boy's gold farm, and I just finished laying out the hopper foundation. So yeah, we actually need 4 separate hopper lines for this farm, because it's actually crazy insane. Actually, I think we might need more than 4 hopper lines, because I'm not entirely sure. I think this farm produces like 45,000 drops an hour, which does require like 5 separate hopper lines, actually. But I think 4 would do. 4 would be fine. I don't really want to waste any more hoppers, and I really know how to configure 5 and make it look, you know, decent. So yeah, 4 hopper lines is fine. So the next thing that we have to do is to make the entire sorting system, which is actually straightforward. We've built sorting systems before. Sorting systems are easy. So yeah, that's all that we need to do. And then after that, we're pretty much done here. Oh yeah, and of course, for the golden swords, we even need to play some furnaces on it. And of course, I don't know if we're doing that now, but a dropper system for the gold ingots would also be good, because we're actually going to connect this to a piglin bartering system. So yeah, I don't know if we're gonna do that now, probably in another episode, because we actually don't have piglins up here yet. But once we do, yeah, we're gonna make, of course, a piglin bartering system somewhere up here. And yeah, that's it. Just build some, you know, sorting systems. Okay, so the entire storage system is now finished, and don't mind that, I just ran out of wood to make more composters, so yeah, I'll probably come back here another time. Oh, my shulker box. I'll probably come back here another time to fill this entire row with composters, but for now, let's leave this project be and go do something else, because I have a lot to do this episode. Actually, I also need to go back to the apocalyptic district, because there's something... a group project that we need to do with the other apocalyptic district people. So where are my rockets? There they are. Okay, let's just go over to the apocalyptic district now and check what we have over there. So I'm now over here at the apocalyptic district, and as you can see, we have a huge hole over here, and this huge hole is actually for slime chunks. Let me just show you. Yeah, see? A bunch of slimes over there. So each of us in the apocalyptic district just need to dig out one chunk, so that we have 4 slime chunks in total, and the others have already finished or have started digging their own slime chunks. And this over here is actually mine, which I need to dig out. So yeah, I need to contribute to the community, dig out a slime chunk, and I'll probably do that all off camera, because I know you guys don't want to see me dig. So yeah, I'll just cut back to when I have most of this hole dug out. So yeah, okay, we now have the entire hole dug out, and look at this thing, it's huge. So yeah, this is gonna be a really huge slime farm in the future, but for now we're not gonna build that yet. We have other things to do. We need to start on a different farm, and yeah, we have a lot of farm builds today, because I enjoy building farms. So yeah, it's one farm after the next. We just finished digging out the hole, and now we have to dig out another hole, but this time in the Nether. But it won't be as big of a digging project as this one. It's gonna be a mini digging project, and I'll show you guys what it'll be later on. So I'm over here at the Double Blaze farm, and I'm just digging an area out. I already started digging, actually. I wasn't able to record earlier on during the digging process, because we were really anxious. Me, Jelly, and Snurps, the three of us were working on this project, and a bunch of us just kept dying. So yeah, I wasn't able to record because we were all just, you know, really frantic and about. But yeah, now that we have a bunch of blazes contained, and I have them contained up there, so that no more blazes spawn, because if you didn't know, spawners actually have a limit to how many mobs they can spawn in at once. For blaze spawners, I believe it's 6. I think that's standard for all spawners. So yeah, there are probably like 6 blazes in that cage over there, and the spawner won't try to spawn in more mobs, which means I'm just free to go down here and work on things. And yeah, I'll probably cut to when more things are happening. And yeah, that's pretty much it. Just, oh, Jelly. Yeah, Jelly's working on the other side, by the way. And he is really apprehensive about lagging out, because the server's lagging out a little bit, because there's, once again, a lot of people online. There usually is a lot of people online nowadays, which is good. You know, active community and stuff like that. But it's not the best for lag circumstances. So yeah, I guess I'm gonna focus on this, make sure I don't break the spawner like what Jelly said, and cut back when, you know, something more is happening. Probably when I build. Oh, by the way, I almost forgot to say, this is actually gonna be an AI-based farm. It was a concept originally put forth by Nembom. It never became an actual full-fledged tutorial or video on his channel. But yeah, the original idea was from Nembom. So I'll probably link to his video down in the description, just so you guys can take a look at it and maybe come up with your own designs for this. It's really simple. Like, that's what I love about it. It's like one of the simplest designs I've seen for a blaze farm ever. Like, ever. It's even simpler than his own past designs, which is great, because I could just come up here, build it quickly, and be done with it. So yeah, that's pretty much it. I'll cut back to when there's more to do, probably when we're actually doing the Blaze collection system and all that. So yeah. Okay, so we've just finished building up the farm. I'll show it to you guys now. Let me just open this up. And yeah, over there is the spawner, and we still have the blazes trapped inside the cage that we have. And we just place some buttons over here so that nothing else can spawn, but the blazes can still, you know, could still like land down here and go through this system. And this system is actually where they will go down. I'm not sure if iron trap doors will work, because when I tried this in my test world, I actually used wooden trap doors. They should work. If not, we can just replace this easily. So yeah. Basically, what this is, this concept that was introduced by Nembom, is that when the blazes land down here, they will want to pathfind somewhere. And they will likely pathfind to this outer area over here. This outer 2-block-high area around the spawning area that we have. And when they do that, the only way to get there is actually through this path. And since mobs can actually pathfind through these trapdoors over here, they will try to go down this hallway. But instead of being able to go through these trapdoors, they'll actually go down and land on those trapdoors over there, where we have some hoppers underneath, and we can go ahead and kill them. So yeah, we could start releasing. Yeah, we could start releasing these monsters out of their cages. And wait, oh, hold on. I just noticed something. We still have this open area up here, which I need to block off. Just give me a sec to block this entire area off, just so that blazes don't come up here. I mean, they probably won't come up here because, you know, since they have nothing to pathfind up here, so they'll just land down to the bottom area. But it's good to just, you know, block this off as well. Why not? If we wooden trapdoors, I have 8. Okay. Okay. We'll see. Yeah, so yeah, we have wooden trapdoors just in case the iron trapdoors won't work. But if the iron trapdoors do work, then that's good. You know, iron trapdoors. Yeah. So, just blocking this off right now. And yeah, the server's a little bit laggy, and so is my client. So, yeah, that's something. But that's okay. Oops. Just gotta move that. Okay. Let's go back down. And I can tell Jelly that we can release the blazes. Okay, so we just finished building up the blaze farms, and this is how this side looks over here. Yep, and now let's go over to the other side just so you guys can see it. It's exactly the same. Both are identical, and oh, there's a wither skeleton there. So yeah, it's exactly identical. It's just the same thing. Just a room where the blazes can spawn, and as you can see, some blazes just spawned in. And when we go down here, this is the killing chamber, and yeah, there are a bunch of blazes already on here. And when you use this farm, you need to stand somewhere, not on these pressure plates, but close enough to the spawner so that blazes spawn in. So yeah, this spot is good. So once enough blazes spawned in and enough of them are inside this killing chamber, you can stand on the pressure plates, and that'll make sure no other blazes go in. And just press this button, and that'll activate the piston crushers, which will suffocate the blazes until they're a one-hit kill. And once they're suffocated enough, you can just hit them with the sword, and that'll kill them, and you'll get some blaze rods out of it. So yeah, that's a pretty good and efficient farm. I really enjoyed building this, and yeah, since there are 2 spawners, it's really fast, actually. Those blaze rods that you saw over there inside this chest, those were actually only after a few minutes of running this farm. So yeah, it's pretty efficient. It's really good. So I think this is where we're gonna end this episode. Actually, I'll do my outro somewhere that's not inside this this fortress. Somewhere that's more, you know, pleasing to the eye. Oh, hello. Let's try killing this guy first. Nothing. Okay, move on to the outro. Okay, so I brought you guys back here because I really enjoy the view of this farm. I mean, just look at it. It's amazing. So yeah, even though this is the third time I built this farm, I still can't get tired of building it. It's really one of my favorite farm builds ever in Minecraft. So yeah, So some of you guys may be worried because this is the second time in a row I've uploaded a Pixel Punch episode, and you might be wondering, where are the Redstone and Farm builds, TP West? Don't worry, they're coming. My next video will be a Redstone build. So don't worry guys, I would still be uploading those stuff. I'm just doing a lot of Pixel Punch episodes right now because the server's just, you know, recently been very active. So I want to be in with the community. So yeah, that's the reason why. So that's pretty much it for this episode. Thank you guys for all of your support. And please like and subscribe if you can. And hit that notification bell. I love all you guys. See you next time. Bye-bye.